Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade.
Yes, I mean, I had a lot of experiences with explaining what Luxembourg is and where it is. I still remember a guy in the U.S., like, he told me, where you're from? You're in my accent. I said, I'm from Luxembourg. And he said, is it a city in Virginia State in the USA? I was like, no, it's a country. It's European. It's a European country.
Yeah. I want to ask you about languages. Three official languages, yes?
That's
German,
right.
French, and Luxembourgish.
Yeah, that's right.
And which language do you use in usual life?
Depends what you mean by usual life.
I mean at home, at school,
yeah.
In university.
Yeah, exactly. At school, like kindergarten, school, people talk Luxembourgish between each other, like the pupils and the teacher, we talk in Luxembourgish. But our books, our textbooks, are usually in German, but we speak in Luxembourgish. Besides school, it really, really depends a lot. In shops, we speak Luxembourgish or French, very often French, because we have a lot of foreigners that work in Luxembourg, lots of French people and Belgians that work in Luxembourg. In companies, professional environment, it's more German, a bit French also, but a lot of German, also English, of course. It varies. We use the three, really. If you want to be at ease in Luxembourg, you need to be able to speak the three languages.
And how is it possible to know all languages? How do you learn it?
We speak the three languages, but doesn't mean we speak them well. If you're born in Luxembourg, you speak well Luxembourgish. If you're born
so
there,
it's your
you grow.
The first language, yes?
It's my first language, but I left my country when I was 10 years old, so it's been a while now. What about people? They don't speak very well French, at least. They have a strong accent. They speak quite well German, because German is very similar to Luxembourgish, so it's super easy, and TV is in German, or cartoons are in German, so German is not a problem at all to learn for people from Luxembourg.
And about Luxembourgish language, is it a mix of German, French, or what is it?
It's really a Germanic language, but with a big French influence, yeah. We have a lot of French words there.
Three countries are neighboring Luxembourg, Germany, France, and Belgium. Are there any influence?
You can see it in food, you can see it in drinks. We eat very much like German, in very similar ways. Kartoffelsalat, I think that's quite famous. We drink a lot of beer, it's also a very German thing.
Luxembourg is a rich country. And how does it influence on people in Luxembourg and on the relationship between neighbors?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we are very, very, very rich. We are one of the richest in the world, or maybe even the first. This is because we have many banks, many insurances. Companies come because we have almost no taxes for them, so they come and put their offices in Luxembourg.
If I want to open a business, I should go to Luxembourg?
So many Russians, they open a business here in Russia, but they open an office in Luxembourg, so they do not pay taxes and they put their money in Luxembourg bank. Every day there are about 150,000 people coming to Luxembourg. Every day, 150 coming, 150 coming in the morning, 150 going out in the evening, the same 150,000. From France and Belgium mostly, because housing is much cheaper in neighboring countries, but salaries are very, very high in Luxembourg. So they have their house in, for example, typical situation, have a house in French part and work in Luxembourg. And they do every day this way. It makes Luxembourg very open to the world, very international. And it's really amazing because you can speak several languages. Practice the language you want, basically, and you have a lot of foreigners too from Portugal, like my dad. You have from Brazil, many Brazilians from Cape Verde, from Spain, from Italy. It's really, really a multicultural country. And this wealth also has an impact on social relationships, because if you live in Luxembourg, you can be bored if you're a young person that needs to party very often, but if you have your own family, it's just perfect, because Luxembourg is a country for families. You have always, almost always, two parents, two kids in a very nice house and a very nice garden, and they don't really go out very often. They don't need to because everything is at home. You have amazing football fields, really just amazingly beautiful, and no one is playing there. And this is really a shame because here in Russia we struggle to find a good field where we can play football.
How can you characterize Luxembourgish?
The language?
No, the people.
The people.
Yes. Are they different from Russian people, for example?
They to some extent different. So if I had to use a few words, the first one that comes to my mind is introvert. They don't open so easily to other people. They tend to be a bit cautious towards other people. The second would be kindness. They are kind. I would almost say innocent. And the third one is they are very proud of their own country, of what they are. The slogan of Luxembourg is, we want to stay who we are. And this is really what Luxembourg is like.
Thank you very much. And you know, in the last video when we asked you about Russia, a lot of people after that video said that you looks like Russian and that you speak like Russian. And now we want.
Why that?
I don't know. So we want to check if you really, if you know a lot of about Russia. And Lera has got some questions for you. And we will check if you're really Russian. I have got some questions for you. And a lot of Russian, I think all Russian people know the answer. So let's check if you know the answers.
All right.
This question. The first question is, what is the name of Russia Santa's granddaughter? Снежинка, Снегурочка, Снеговик.
Снегурочка.
Yeah, correct. What is latte? Shoes, dish, or light alcoholic drink?
I don't know. What is it? Yakutian shoes?
Yeah, it's shoes.
Yeah.
What do Russian people use in Bania? Broom and hat, fan and felt boots, mask and fins.
So they use this this hat, mm-hmm. and they use the thing to to heat. To make water vapor, that's how you call broom and broom.
Yeah, what does the phrase yes, no, maybe mean in Russia? Yes,
Daniel,
no.
Yeah,
Daniel.
This means most likely no, right? Mm-hmm. Most likely no. But maybe like an open no. Yeah. I hear it very often. It's like there's another one the Russians use, it's like Daniel, but this is like a niet at the end, so close. Yeah. Daniel Navierna is probably more like a no.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, correct.
It's not always like good news when someone says
it. And now I will tell you about five superstitions, and some of them are real, some of them are not real, so I try to guess what is real. The first one is a bit superstition to wash hair before the exam.
No, I don't know about this one.
It's correct.
So it's correct? It's a superstition.
We try to don't wash our hair in the morning, for example, because it means that we will not pass the exam or we will forget a bad mark. The second, it's a bad superstition for a girl to sit at the corner of the table.
Yes, because it means you're never gonna get married.
Yeah, correct. It's a bad superstition to see a woman with bucket. Bucket.
Is it bucket.
Как это?
Ведром, maybe, no?
Ведро. It's a circle.
When you wash, clean the floor, you put this.
Okay.
Yes, yes, to water.
Okay.
It's a bad superstition to see a woman with a bucket of water.
I never heard of this one. Is it real?
No.
Okay,
it's a bad superstition to see a woman with empty bucket. Without anything. It means that you will forget a bad day.
Oh, really?
Yeah. The next
so
one.
You should always have water with you and ready to fill the bucket, yeah?
Yeah. It's a bit superstition to sleep with open windows.
I think it could be real, because maybe Russians are cold, are afraid of cold coming in.
It's true. And the last one, it's a bit superstition to whistle inside.
To whistle inside. Well, it could be a bad superstition, but I didn't hear about this one.
Yeah, it's a bad superstition. It means that you will be poor, that you will not have good money.
I know another superstition where if you want to avoid things to happen, you touch the wood three times and then...
Yeah, that's
and then
why
you spit and then you go.
You know that now all people would think that you're really Russian because you answered all questions.
Well, it's an honor, I hope. Yeah, it's an honor. I still need to improve my Russian language, but I want to be as similar to Russians as possible.